reconciliation, the Muslims they broke up into sects. And then he mentioned Al-Jahmiyyah, and then Al-Mu'tazila, then Al-Ash'ari, نعم وصوفية. Now Al-Jahmiyyah, they are the worst of all of these. And Al-Jahmiyyah, they are the followers of Al-Jahm bin Safwan. There's a man called Al-Jahm ibn Safwan. Al-Jahm bin Safwan, he had a teacher called Al-Ja'd bin Dirham. And Al-Ja'd bin Dirham was killed, was executed by the governor of Iraq. His name is Khalid al-Qasri. Khalid al-Qasri. He killed him on the day of Eid al-Adha. The day of Eid al-Adha, he killed him. And the reason being, because Al-Ja'd ibn Dirham, he said Allah did not speak to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. And Allah did not take Ibrahim as his Khalil. So basically, this is a denial to the Quran. Because when you deny the Quran, you commit kufr. So because of this, he was executed. But his aqidah went to his students, Al-Jahm bin Safwan. Al-Jahm bin Safwan, he started preaching the aqidah of his sheikh, his teacher. And in brief, Al-Jahmiyyah, number one calamity, they are mu'attila. They negate all the names and attributes of Allah Azza wa Jal. For example, they say Sami'un bila Sam', Basirun bila Basar, that Allah sees with no sight and He hears with no hearing. This is impossible. It's impossible. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they believe that Allah hears in a way that befits His Majesty. But how He hears, we have no knowledge. Na'am? And Imam Malik rahimahullah, when the man asked him a question, he said, Ya Aba Abdillah, Ar-Rahmanu ala al-Arsh istawa, kayfa istawa? He said, Aba Abdillah, how did that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rose over the throne? How did He rose over the throne? Then Imam Malik, he answered him, he said, Al-Istiwa'u ma'loom, wal-kayfu majhool, wal-imanu bihi wajib, wal-su'alu anu bid'ah. He said, rahimahullah ta'ala, to the man, Al-Shaykh al-Uthaymin, he said, before he answered him, he hung his head down. And his forehead was full of sweat. So that shows you the severity of this affair. The affair of the aqeedah is not easy. Na'am. And when you speak about Allah Azza wa Jal, you better be right. Na'am. So he said to him, he rose over the throne is known. Because Ahlul Sunnah, they affirm the meaning. They affirm the meaning. If Allah said he rose over the throne, we affirm that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rose over the throne. But how He rose over the throne? We don't know. We leave that to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So He told him, Ar-Rahman, He said He rose over the throne is known by the Quran. Because Allah said so. Wal-kayfu, and how He rose over the throne? Majhul, unknown. Wal-imanu bihi wajib, and to believe in that is obligatory upon you. والسؤال عنه بدعة. And to ask a question like that is an innovation. Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen, he said, the companions of Prophet ﷺ, even though they were eloquent in their Arabic, نعم, and they had the fear of Allah, and they had all these good quality, they never asked the Prophet ﷺ, how does Allah rise above the throne? Never. نعم. So we should have adab and etiquette with Allah Azza wa Jal. If something we have no knowledge about, we zip it up. We don't say anything. نعم. طيب. The first calamity, يا إخوان, الجهمية, تعطيل. Then he gave all the names and attributes. The second, الإرجاع. Because الجهمية, they are the extreme مرجع. Extreme. Okay? What is الإرجاع? الإرجاع in the Arabic language, when you say أرجع الشيء أخره. When you postpone something, or you put it off on the side. Okay, that's in the language. طيب in the legislative meaning of الإرجاء is when you don't include الإيمان the good deeds in الإيمان. Okay, so المرجئة they hold the opinion and the belief that الأعمال the good deeds صلاة زكاة fast حج other than that they don't hold them to be an integral part of الإيمان. طيب, so according to them, as long as you believe in Allah with your heart, you have complete iman. You agree or disagree? You agree with them or disagree with them? What you say?
Agree.
Agree?
Disagree.
Disagree. Disagree. Disagree. Yeah, okay, I'm going to go through it again. Al-Murji'a, they believe, Al-Jahmiya, they believe that as long as you acknowledge your Lord with your heart, you believe in Him, then you have complete iman. طيب, we disagree with them. How is that? Because if that was correct, then Pharaoh would have been a believer. What is the proof from the Quran? Can anybody give me the ayah from the Quran about this? Anybody can give me the ayah from the Quran? Anybody knows? Okay, I will mention the ayah. Allah said in the Quran about Fir'aun, Pharaoh, and those who were with him. وَجَحَدُوا بِهَا وَاسْتَيْقَنَتْهَا أَنفُسُهُمْ ظُلْمًا وَعُلُوًا. وَجَحَدُوا بِهَا وَاسْتَيْقَنَتْهَا أَنفُسُهُمْ ظُلْمًا وَعُلُوًا. They rejected the sign that Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام brought. Even though they were certain in their heart, it was the truth. This is the point of reference, ya ikhwan. محل الشاهد. نعم. واستيقنوا بها يا أخي. Still I'm doubtful about the two surahs. I'm not sure, but I don't want to give you, mislead you. But inshallah, after inshallah, I'll find out for you. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وجحدوا بها, and they rejected it. واستيقنتها أنفسهم, while their heart was certain this is the truth. Subhanallah. Look, istinbat ya ikhwan, al-ulama, how they bring the ayat from the Quran. طيب, واستيقنتها أنفسهم ظلما وعلوا. Why did they reject it? While they knew it's the truth. In their heart, they have no doubt. But why? He said, ظلما وعلوا. By way of what? Transgression and oppression. And by way of what? Haughtiness and arrogance. That's why they rejected it. Or even though, as Sheikh Uthaymeen, when he was explaining in Al-Qawl Al-Mufid, نعم, the explanation of Kitab Al-Tawheed, he said, no one denied Tawheed Al-Rububiyyah. Even Al-Kuffar, they did not deny Tawheed Al-Rububiyyah. نعم, Abu Jahl and those who were with him, نعم, they did not deny Tawheed Al-Rububiyyah. Allah said about them in the Quran, وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَهُمْ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ. If you were to ask Muhammad, who created them, they would surely say, Allah. If you ask them, who created heaven and earth, they would surely say, Allah. They did not deny Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. He said, except by way of al-mukabara, Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen said. By way of mukabara means by way of arrogance, like Pharaoh. وَجَحَدُوا بِهَا وَاسْتَيْقَنَتْهَا أَنفُسُهُمْ ظُلْمًا وَعُلُوًا. So this is a refutation against the extreme al-murji'ah, that based upon your belief, Pharaoh will be with you. نعم, and not only Pharaoh. Who else, ya ikhwan? Abu Talib. Abu Talib. Did he believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Yes, he did. He believed in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He believed. As a matter of fact, he said it. He said, وَإِنِّي لَأَعْلَمُ أَنَّ خَيْرَ الْبَرِيَّةِ أَنَّ دِينَ مُحَمَّدٍ مِنْ خَيْرِ الْبَرِيَّةِ دِينَ. He said that. He said, I know that the religion of Muhammad is the best of the religion. Best. نعم. But why, يا إخوان? Going back to the statement of the Shaykh, the disease. What? Being fanatic to the ajdad, to the ancestors and the tribalism and the like. Naam? You see, Because Abu Jahl, he told him, you're not going to die upon the belief of your tribe. So he died upon the belief of the tribe. Now, so it shows you, Ikhwan, the affair of being fanatic to a tribe or to an individual is serious. Has very serious consequences in the end. Naam, ya Ikhwan. So, the second matter, ya Ikhwan, al-irja. Al-irja. Naam. Al-irja. And al-murji'a, they hold the belief that the worst of the sinners and the best of the believers, like for example, they say that the belief of Abu Bakr Siddiq, radiallahu anh, is as good as the belief of the worst sinners. You agree with them or disagree? Disagree. Why, ya Ikhwan? Because Ahlul Sunnah, we hold the belief that an iman does what? Fluctuates. Al-iman yazid wa yanqus. Naam? Al-iman increases and decreases. And that's why they said, al-imanu qawlun bil-lisan. Wa'atiqadun bil-janan. Wa'amalun bil-jawarih. Aw bil-arkan. Yazid bil-ta'ati wa yanqusu bil-ma'asiyah. That al-iman is a statement of the tongue, belief of the heart, followed by actions of the body, all of them together. You can't say, well, al-a'mal, they are a condition for the validity of al-iman. They are a condition for the completeness of al-iman. Na'am, like murji'at fuqaha. La. Al-a'mal, they are integral part in al-iman. Likewise, al-arkan in the salat, they are an integral part in the salat. Na'am, likewise. Because ash-shurut, conditions, they're outside. So how you can say condition? La, al-a'mal, all of them, al-a'mal, statement, na'am, and belief of the heart, and actions of the body. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, He said, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُضِيعَ إِيمَانَكُمْ وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُضِيعَ إِيمَانَكُمْ And Allah will not, na'am, cause your iman to be lost. What iman is this? Salat. Salat toward Jerusalem. Because the Muslims in the beginning, they used to face Jerusalem. So that time, all that time, would they be rewarded for that? Yes, Allah comforted them. He said, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُضِيعَ إِيمَانَكُمْ And he called Salat, he called it what? Iman. He called it Iman. And that's why the ulama, they say, الإسلام والإيمان. طيب, الإسلام والإيمان, when they are together, they are mentioned together in one sentence. Na'am. Then al-Iman is the internal things like belief in Allah, love of Allah, tawakkul ala Allah, and other than that, this is Iman. And al-Islam is the outward actions like as-Salat, like al-Hajj, and other than that. Na'am. So that's why they say, إِذَا اجْتَمَعَ مَاذَا افْتَرَقَ وَإِذَا افْتَرَقَ اجْتَمَعَ When they are together, they mention together, then the meaning vary. Na'am? And when they are mentioned separately, Islam is mentioned by itself, like for example in Surah Ali Imran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ The religion with Allah is Islam. Is al-Iman included or not? Yes, it is included. So, when al-Iman is mentioned individually, then al-Islam enters. When al-Islam enters individually, al-Iman enters. When they are together, al-Islam is the outward action and al-Iman is the internal actions of the heart. Inam. I don't know if I have more time, but there is a lot more to be said. We're going to stop right here. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us all al-ilm al-nafi' wal-amal salih. والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وعلى اله وصحبه بارك الله فيكم يا نعم نعم لا that's okay ان شاء الله نعم
okay so we have 10 minutes
we can still go
yeah
نعم طيب نعم نعم طيب the other calamity يا اخوان that al-Jahmiyyah have beside at-ta'til, negating the names and attributes, they have what we mentioned, the extreme al-irja' and they also have al-jabr. Al-jabr. And they are called what? Jabriya. When you hear this term, Jabriya, you have to know what the scholars are talking about. Okay? They say sometimes, like in the science of the hadith, when they talk about certain narrators, They say فلان ثقة لكنه كان يرى الجبر. لكنه كان يرى الجبر. أو فلان مثلا ثقة لكنه كان يرى الإرجاء. I understand what الإرجاء, الجبر and all this. الجبر basically, there are two sects. There is a sect called القدرية. And these are المعتزلة. نعم. الجبرية, الجبرية either they are from الجهمية or they are from الأشاعرة as well. Because الأشاعرة also, they are جبرية. Okay, now, break it down for you. القدرية, they believe that the actions of a slave, okay, when you talk, when you walk, when you write, when you eat, when you drink, huh? When you pray, and all these things, they say these are created by the slaves. نعم. Allah did not create that. But the slaves create their actions. It's very serious. And that's why the ulama, they call these people majus. They call them the magian, the fire worshippers. Then someone may wonder, what is the connection between the fire worshippers and these individuals? Because when you look at the fire worshippers, ya ikhwan, نعم, you find out that they believe that there are two deities. The deity of light, that's why they worship the fire. And the deity of darkness. نعم, the deity of light and the deity of darkness. طيب, now, this Qadariya, they believe that Allah created the heaven and earth and everything else. But the actions of the servant, the servant create them. Now when they say that, now they have two what? Two ilah. They have two ilah. That's why they call them majus. They call them the magian and the fire worshippers of this ummah. طيب, these are al-qadariya. Now we're going to go to al-jabriya. Spoke about al-jabr. طيب. Al-jabriya, they believe that you have no free will. Okay? You have no free will. طيب. When you commit the sin, نعم, you're forced to commit the sin. Do you agree with them or disagree? I want to just say what you said. Disagree. No, disagree.
Disagree.
No doubt. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave us a will. نعم, He gave us a will. Allah said in the Quran, وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إلا أن يشاء الله. Whatever you will, Allah's will precedes our will, no doubt. But it doesn't mean that we can do things. Like me now, I'm talking to you, you know, freely and all that. I can drink if I wish. Alhamdulillah, I can pick up the bottle. Bismillah, I drink. You know, this is written. Allah knows I'm going to do this. But Allah gave us a will. Okay. So when you commit a sin, we don't say, "Well, Allah forced me to commit the sin." And that's why Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen, he mentioned that one of these individuals, he was brought to Umar al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, because he committed theft. And Umar al-Khattab was going to chop off his hand because he committed theft. نعم. So when he was about to chop off his head, his hand, he told him, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, I committed this sin by the Qadr of Allah. نعم. He said, and we're going to cut off your hand by the Qadr of Allah as well. نعم. نعم. And that's why Shaykh Islam ibn Taymiyyah, in his book, Risala, رَفْعُ الْمَلَامِ عَنِ الْأَئِمَّةِ الْأَعْلَامِ, lifting the blame over the scholars of Islam, and he mentioned that how the companions of Ridwanullahi alayhim, sometimes they used to differ. نعم. So that differing is not something new. Even the Sahaba did it. And then he mentioned the story when they were going to Great Syria and they heard of an epidemic, like what you call today Ebola and the like, something like that. طيب. Now, when he heard that, they were arguing among each other. Should we go to that place or should we go back to Medina? نعم. And then Abdurrahman ibn Auf, he was traveling, he came. He told them, I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said that if you are not there yet, go back. And that's why you find al-ulama, Lijna al-Da'im al-Ifta, and others, they go with these ahadith as a qawaid. They use them. Like some of them, they say, look, at the time of the epidemic, they have to make sure that nobody has it. Damn. It doesn't mean that we don't accept the qadr. We accept the qadr, but we have to take precautions as well. Now, this is Islam. This is Islam. Some of the people say, whatever happens is going to happen. Yes, whatever happens is going to happen. But you have to take the precautions. Now, you see, the extreme Sufiya, they used to go out. As the Imam Ibn al-Jawzi, rahimahullah, mentioned, some of them, they go out without provisions. And one time, one of them, he was going out without provisions, the Ikhwan, and they came across lions. They were eating a carcass of a dead camel. He said his soul started getting scared. He said, I had to control it, subhanAllah. So he had to sit in front of those lions eating that carcass, subhanAllah. Allahu musta'an. So Ibn al-Jawzi commented those, he said, yeah, miskeen. Those lions, they were full. If they were hungry, they would have started with you first before they go to the carcass. Yeah. So this aqeedah, ya ikhwan, of Sufiya is very, very dangerous. Very backward, very dangerous. Now, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to take provision when he travels. Now, that way we put our trust in Allah. How you sit in the masjid and everything's going to come to you. It's not going to happen. You got to go, look for a job. Now, طيب يا أخوان, these are al-Jahmiya, ya أخوان. Al-Jahmiya, they have many calamities. Number one, al-Ta'atil. Number two, al-Irja. Number three, al-Jabr. As we mentioned here, al-Jabr, that they say you have no free will. And there was a beautiful story I read long time ago about al-Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. I will conclude by this, that an atheist came to al-Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. And he was with his students. He was in the introduction of a book of fiqh. I can't remember, been years ago. But this man came up. Al-Imam Abu Hanifa was in the circle of knowledge with his students. And he had a clay pot next to him. He uses for wudu. So this man, he said, I have three challenging questions for you. And expect you to have the answer. He said, go ahead. He said, how is it possible in the world that I'm going to worship Allah and I don't see him? How can I worship something I don't see? Naam, that's the first one. Second one, how is it possible in the world that Allah will punish the jinn with the fire while he created them from the same substance? Naam. It shows you, Ikhwan, the superiority of al-ilm. He said, the third matter, he said, how is it possible that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish me for something he decreed that I was going to do? Well, this is what aqidat what? Al-Jabriya. Al-Imam Abu Hanifa, he picked up the pot and he hit him in the head. Until he screamed his head off.
You are wrong.
Yes. But now more benefit is going to come. You'll see. So he hit him in the head until he screamed his head. He went to the judge and he filed a suit against Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. They came to court. The judge turned to Imam, why did you hit this man? He said, I hit this man because of three reasons. So he turned to him. He said, when I hit you with this, you claim that how can you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you don't see him? He said, when I hit you with the clay pot, did you see the pain? He said, no. Did you feel it? He said, oh yeah, I felt it. He said, likewise, when you believe in Allah, you're going to feel an iman in your heart. طيب, the second one, ya ikhwan. He told him, how is it possible in the world that Allah will punish the jinn with the fire? And he created them from fire. He said, when I hit you with the clay pot, Allah said in the Quran about this, that he created man from what? From clay. Did you feel it? He said, yeah, I felt it. Naam. You see, the third one, you're using al-qadr as an excuse. He said, when I hit you with the clay pot, you had two choices. You either fight back, or you go to the judge. But with your own choice, you went to the judge. He said, yes. Shut him down. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us al-ilm al-nafi' al-amal salih. Walhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi.